at Rice. And so it begins.
Let the game begin.
We'll let you in. Very good.
Well, all this growth Mark Sanchez had from year one to year two.
Hello, LaDainian Tomlinson is here. Sean Green, the second year back out of Iowa, is the starter for New York. And from the 21, quickly into the hands of Braylon Edwards, reversing for four to the 25. Juwan Landry makes the tackle. Let's go through the Jets offense, and they were ground and pound. They ran it as much as anyone in the NFL last year.
Well, they ran it over 600 times. They have a new tailback featuring Sean Green from Iowa. Keep an eye on Matt Slauson, number 78. He's playing left guard tonight as he fills in for Alan Faneca, number 68. I'm sorry.
Alan Faneca, the nine-time Pro Bowler, is now an Arizona Cardinal. And Slauson, in his second year out of Nebraska, has become the starter. After the gain of four, out of the gun with Sanchez. Pressure right away from Ray Lewis is picked up, and Sean Green with the first down lost the ball, but out of bounds. Get first down at the 37-yard line. A gain of 12.
Sanchez does a nice job of keeping his focal point down the field. He knows he doesn't get the play down the field. He's going to check it out to the sideline to Sean Green. You'll see Sanchez looking down the field. That keeps those defenders in place. Doesn't have it. Doesn't have that stick throw. Dump it off. You will see a lot more passes to the backs this year than you saw last year from Mark Sanchez.
Good job by the official. Came back and moved the spot to where the ball hit out of bounds at the 34. So it's a gain of nine. The rookie John Connor, known as the Terminator for his big hits, is the fullback. He leads the way for Green. Only a gain of a couple of yards. John, what are you looking for in Sanchez here as we try to see where he's elevated from last year's game?
Well, let's remember, he's a second-year quarterback. There's a lot of pressure on him with all the bravado, all the predictions coming out of here. He has got to take better care of the football. 20 interceptions last year, 10 fumbles. They must throw the football better for the Jets to get to that Super Bowl that they crave.
LaDainian Tomlinson checks in for the Jets. He's the motion man, motioning back to the tailback spot. Take on the toss, the pass, well covered. Braylon Edwards, no room against Chris Carr. Ron, this is a Ravens defense where the front seven's going to have to hold it for a little bit because of some injuries in the secondary.
Well, they are a very disciplined defense, Mike, and you saw it right there. The misdirection play. Trying to take advantage of an over-aggressive Ravens defense. Ray Lewis read it perfectly. They tried to sneak the back out in the flat. He covered the back, and he forced a deeper throw for Sanchez.
There's Ed Reed not here on the physically unable to perform list. Can come back after week six. He's not in the lineup. He's here on the sideline. Third and eight. Pressure comes from Sanchez's right. His throw is off the hands of Dustin Keller. Incomplete. Covered by Tavares Gooden. The Jets pick up one first down and will be forced to punt.
But it was good recognition by the Jets offensively. Tomlinson came across the formation, picked up the blitz. You got to give the Ravens credit. They're missing some key guys in the secondary, but they get a key third down stop.
Tom Zbikowski from Notre Dame, who was an honorable mention All-America punt returner in his junior year in South Bend. He'll be the lead punt returner for the Ravens tonight. Steve Weatherford won the punting job for the Jets, battling T.J. Connelly in preseason. Good kick, 53 yards. He took Zbikowski to the sideline. Nice move by Zbikowski, and his return will be 9 yards. He'll probably mark him around the 20. And Vernon Golston, the first-round bust coming into this year, has had a good preseason. Makes the stop. Joe Flacco and the Ravens offense get their first crack when you come back. As it was earlier tonight, delaying the start of the game 15 minutes. But has not slowed down that gentleman. We went to the timeout. Jets defense came on the field. Huge cheer going up for this unit and Darrell Revis after his long
to start the game for the Ravens. Protection. That ball has got to come out in three
by the Jets.
Brian Thomas and Sean Ellis, first-round picks of the Jets back in 2002, make a Flacco sandwich, force the turnover. Tomlin's in the back. The 2 yards to the nine, and guys, this is exactly what you talked about. Huge turnovers in this game. You cannot afford to give teams field position like this.
Absolutely, and the New York Jets, the Baltimore Ravens, two teams that play great defense. This game will be decided by field position and turnovers. That's a horrible start for the Ravens.
And John, you mentioned the cut blocks by the offensive lineman. That means the ball's going to come out in like 1.5 seconds. It did not come out quickly. The Jets have great field position. Now they have to punch it in.
Right. Not going to get down here often in all likelihood. Sanchez looking for Keller. His tight end was covered. Now he gets it to him at the five. It'll be third and about 3.5. Chris Carr, the nickel over there with the stop.
Well, it's the second time the New York Jets have run a naked bootleg, and you can do that when you have a strong running game. But the Ravens do an excellent job of defending the perimeter. They put pressure from Haloti Ngata right in Sanchez's face, and there's nowhere to go. Sanchez does a nice job finding some work late. Key third down.
You get a first down right at the one.
You get 5-2. You're in the 9-5.
Tomlinson empties the backfield. Sanchez. They'll go for the field goal. Braylon Edwards blanketed by Chris Carr.
Well, I'm not so sure. A good stick throw by Mark Sanchez in that situation would not have resulted in a touchdown for the Jets. Yet Braylon Edwards running the back line of the end zone after the play broke down. You'll see Braylon Edwards, number 6, 17 to the right of your screen. Plays dead. Now he breaks open back to the inside, but the ball is overthrown.
Now the Ravens defense with a very short field, forcing the field goal attempt by Nick Folk. Went to the Pro Bowl with Dallas in 07. Jets didn't keep Jay Feely. Folk got the job and knocks down a 23-yard field goal as the post play pushing and shoving continues. The big hit. Ellis and Thomas get Flacco. They get the ball, and the Jets get the lead. You get a look at the new Meadowlands Stadium. Giant Stadium used to sit in the parking lot. It was knocked down May 19th. Raised. You wouldn't know it was ever there when you drive by now. The stadium, 2.1 million square feet, twice the size of the old joint. And co-owned by both the Jets and the Giants. And a lot of electronics switched around to get it looking green instead of blue yesterday to today. Well, Joe Flacco has done great things in his first 2 years, but not the first snap of 2010. The turnover led to the Jets' field goal. Folk kicking Jalen Parmalee back deep to receive for Baltimore. Turned by Parmalee, brought down to the 30 by Eric Smith. Back to the turnover, John.
Well, when you throw a three-step drop, you tell your offensive line to be aggressive and cut block. And with that being said, that ball's got to be thrown in three-step timing. And if Todd Heap isn't open, you have to throw the football away. You cannot hold it when you allow your offensive line to use that aggressive three-step cut blocking technique.
And John, I agree with you. Wasn't there. You got Ray Rice checking it down. Not there. Don't be afraid to check it down. Do not hold on to the football against this Jets defense. They are coming. They are very aggressive. If the timing and rhythm, the pass game isn't there, throw it away.
First down from the 30. Rice. No gain. Brian Thomas making the top with Bowa, the stop with Bowa. Let's talk about the Ravens offense and Flacco. We talk about his growth. What about the people around him? The cast is better.
No question, there's a better cast. When you look at Anquan Boldin and T.J. Hoogmanzada, they certainly will help Joe Flacco in the passing game, particularly working the interior of the defense, the hash area. They're wily, savvy veterans.
Jared Gaither would have been the starting right tackle. He's been out all of camp with a back injury. So Chester's a guard. Yanda moves over to tackle from guard. And nobody can block the Jets. Rice is stopped for no gain by Bart Scott and Antonio Cromartie.
Well, there's a lot going on there with the Ravens. They shifted to an unbalanced line. They brought both tackles over to the right. They run their one-back power play. They're trying to load up this formation and run that ball off the right side and try to slow down the Jets' blitzes. A lot of teams don't blitz an unbalanced line, but there's just nothing there.
This is a big blitz down for the Jets. Third and over seven. Flacco pressure. Got rid of it to Bolden. Anquan Bolden makes his first catch. A marker's down as he's down at the 45-yard line. Walt Anderson is our referee tonight.
Holding number 24, defense. The penalty is declined. First down.
On Darrell Revis, that declined, and the Ravens have a first down.
Well, there he is, Darrell Revis against Mason in bump and run. He hooked him right there with his left arm. You have to credit the Ravens for picking up that blitz. We got to keep a close eye on Revis tonight, Mike. See what kind of football shape he's in. He's missed 36 days.
First and 10 for the Ravens. Flacco screens to Willis McGahee. Nowhere to go. Loss of six. The game's being played on the other side of the line of scrimmage by the Jets defense.
Jets defensive line, good interior pressure, but it was a screen pass to Willis McGahee. But great reaction by the Jets defense to that screen pass.
We're going to spin through the names of the Jets defense here. John mentioned Revis. What would you do to test Revis's football shape?
Well, I might send a guy on a clear out route, try to throw it in behind him. But sooner or later, we have to see what kind of football shape Darrell Revis is in. It might not be in this quarter. It might be in the second half at some point.
Guarding 14-year veteran Derek Mason. There's a handoff to LaRon McClain, who went to the Pro Bowl as a fullback. Looks like one of the Jets is shaking up. Is that Chris Jenkins? Yeah, Chris Jenkins is grabbing his knee, and that's a big story. Jenkins, who had ACL surgery in November, is such a big difference maker on this Jets defense. When he was out, the Jets defense wasn't as good. Contemplated retirement, came back a little bit lighter, but he's shaking up here early. A timeout. Chris Jenkins has been voted to the Pro Bowl four times. He tore his left ACL last year, had surgery in November. When healthy and on the field, he really controls the point and is a big difference maker. Here's what happened on this play. You see him get tangled up there. And that left knee with that foot getting stuck underneath him. Taking the brunt of it, Jenkins walks off under his own power, but certainly will be looked at by the Jets medical staff.
It's almost amazing you could walk away from that one.
Wow.
Just hope he's all right.
Knee and ankle both buckled.
It does change what the Jets do defensively up front. Matt Kroll is in there replacing Jenkins. It's third and 13 for the Ravens.
These are disaster downs.
Pressure picked up. Flacco with time. Throws complete to his tight end, Todd Heap. First down into Jets territory for the Ravens' all-time career reception leader.
Nice play by Flacco and Todd Heap. But watch Ray Rice pick up the blitz. Eric Smith coming from the right side. That is a great job by Ray Rice picking up a blitz flush, letting Joe Flacco finish the throw. Big third down conversion.
Game of 16, so after the disastrous first play, nice drive here for the Ravens. A couple of third down conversions on the Jets. Nowhere to go for Rice. Gains barely a half yard. So all these guys that the Ravens added, TJ Houshmandzadeh, they picked up from Seattle here at the end of the preseason, Anquan Bolden in the offseason. Jaws, what does it do to this Ravens offense?
Well, first of all, they're going to be a running team. That's where it starts.
Still.
They're going to be a running football team. You have Ray Rice. You know, you have a LaRon McClain. You have a Willis McGahee and a power running offensive line. But when they get in those passing situations, when they get behind in games, that's when those new receivers will be a huge help.
Couple tight ends close to you, including the rookie, Ed Dixon. Flacco has time. He's got Bolden, who catches so many balls at the line of scrimmage or behind the line. And he moves it to third and short coming up for Baltimore. Jim Leonard made the tackle.
the thing Anquan Boldin still does as well as anybody in this league is run after the catch. This might be the toughest wide receiver in the league. He's going to come in motion. Little fake end around, play action pass down the field. Anquan Boldin is the outlet receiver. Let's see Cromartie.
You get Derek Mason by the scruff of the neck. And those two continue in the love fest. Willis McGahee comes back for third and three. And Flacco's throw is complete again to Todd Heap in front of his former teammate Jim Leonard, a Raven first down job at the 30.
You know, when you get three receivers and you spread them to the right side of the formation, there goes those three corners. You get Todd Heap man-to-man against the safety, and that's easy pickings for Todd Heap. He's done that for years. That's a joker, Jaws. They can line up Todd Heap in any hand, and he can deliver.
McGahee, the running back. And Flacco, play action. Looking toward Heap. Almost brought it in for the touchdown. Kyle Wilson, the Jets' first-round pick out of Boise State from Piscataway, New Jersey. Very close to here. Made the play.
It should have been a touchdown, Mike. You'll see Todd Heap on the seam route from the tight position straight up the field on Kyle Wilson. Kyle Wilson stopped moving his feet. Heap got behind him and dropped the football. Right there, it's on his hands. If he caught it cleanly, Wilson would not have been able to knock that ball down.
The Raven has caught more TDs in their franchise's decade and a half history. He's got 36. Should have had 37. Race to the left. Jason Taylor. Yes, that's Jet fans cheering for you, Jason Taylor. They hated him when he was a Dolphin for many years. First year as a Jet.
Jason Taylor replacing Calvin Pace, who was outstanding against the run, but so is Jason Taylor. Look at the job he does with his hands. He's not the biggest, he's not the strongest, but he separates because he has strong hands and sheds the blocker. Jason Taylor's always gotten great credit being a pass rusher. He could play the run very well.
Third and 13. Third and 18.
False start. Number 27. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
I'll tell you why there's a penalty. The New York Jets are coming with all-out pressure. And those offensive linemen, they're trying to communicate with one another. Take a look at it. Make no mistake about it. The Jets are bringing everybody after Joe Flacco to try to knock him out of field.
Look at that middle of the field. There's nobody there.
John Harbaugh was arguing, hey, backs off and move up to hear the snap count or something and communicate. But that was the spirit of the rule called correctly. They've made third and nine. They've made third and 13 on this drive. Third and 18 will be a holding penalty. Pass on the sideline through the incomplete and out of bounds. But Sean Ellis was pulled down. A holding call is coming up. From here, a field goal will be 55 yards. The ball's at the 37. Still having a conversation over here about a catch or no catch. The initial ruling was no catch, incomplete. Walt Anderson wants to come find that out for us. It would be shy of the first down. It would be fourth down at the 25. So I'll be able to give Rex Ryan all of his options here. Let's see if it was a catch or no catch first.
The ruling on the field was a completed pass.
Absolutely not.
Holding, number 65, offense, 10-yard penalty, still third down.
I'll take it back. Looked like his knee was down as he caught the ball out of bounds. But here's the flag for the hole that negates it all anyway.
Well, penalties are going to be a big part of this game. Here comes another blitz. You see the right guard, Chris Chester, just pulling down Ellis. And those penalties are costly. They knock you out of field position. The Ravens led the NFL in penalties last year. That's back-to-back penalties that have really stymied this drive.
And, John, that one was even big because they used a little check down to Ray Rice. He blocked and then checked down. He was wide open. If Flacco would have had time, I think the Ravens had an opportunity for a big play.
Yeah, good luck, third and 28 against this defense.
Yes, thanks. You make the call, Coach.
Blackwell's got some time. He's got Ray Rice. Flag down in the secondary. Flag down late in the play in the secondary. Thrown toward the conversation with T.J. Hushmanzada and one of the Jet DBs, Kyle Wilson.
Well, if it's defensive holding, it's a disaster play.
Holding, number 20. Ooh. Defense. Five-yard penalty. First down.
That's how you convert third and 28. Give me a five-yard D holding for the automatic first down. Killer. That's the rookie Wilson's call.
Well,
wow.
There's your rookie corner.
It's on Hushmanzada, the receiver, 84.
I mean, you're going to see Kyle Wilson, the rookie out of Boise State, their first-round draft choice. It's a maximum protection. He grabs Hushmanzada. Referee makes the right call. What a critical penalty on 3rd and 28.
Running a 5-yard little jerk route in there, wheeling back out. He catches it 3rd and 4th and 23.
Timeout is called by the Ravens. With 3:04 left in the opening quarter, and Baltimore on a 7.5-minute drive. ESPN kick time will be 10:20 Eastern, 9:20 out in Kansas City. So stay tuned for game two of the doubleheader. Ravens have had it for 7.5 minutes. Get a first down off the defensive holding penalty on the rookie Wilson. Flacco sets up a screen. It's a very good screen team. Ray Rice got two blocks and takes it to the Jets' 27-yard line. Pickup of 15 and a first down.
And offensive coordinator Cam Cameron doing an excellent job changing personnel. That time they brought in two tight ends and two backs. That's a hard formation for Rex Ryan to blitz. And Cam Cameron throws a screen to Ray Rice. Watch it. Flacco looks left. He gives ground. He sees the throw to Ray Rice. Right down the numbers he goes. Good execution. Cam Cameron doing an excellent job with personnel substitutions.
And watch Ed Dixon, number 83. He's the speed tight end when he's in the game.
He's the rookie out of Oregon. Toss to Rice left. Pulling to lead the way was Michael Orr, who was the right tackle last year. Now he's the left tackle. Leading the way for Ray Rice at 5'8", 212. Only had scholarship offers from Virginia and Syracuse, but the guy from just north of New York City, New Rochelle, got a last-minute offer from Rutgers. Had a great career not too far from here in New Jersey, and it's turned into excellent NFL season so far.
And John spoke
of the season again
by Bart Scott. Continues to stay after McGahee and creates the fumble. That's
I love
effort.
That. Yeah, that's a hot stove drill, man. When you get it knocked down the ground, get up and go find the ball. Heck of a play by Bart Scott.
Mark Sanchez comes out to receiver, and Brad Smith lines up as the quarterback. Jets show the pistol formation. And with Tony Richardson blocking, Brad Smith, the former prolific college quarterback at Missouri, John, with a nice game.
Well, they can do so many things running the football, and Brad Smith is another element. He played the quarterback position, as you said, Mike. He's a threat, a legitimate threat, to run all kind of options and throw the football. This guy runs 4-4 and is
almost in runs left. Gain of only a yard. Terrell Suggs, difficult year last year after the huge free agency deal, has come back for a very good camp. Makes the play there to end the first quarter. A couple of turnovers by the Ravens. The Jets have 3 points. It's been a word or two exchanged. After one, the Jets 3, the Ravens nothing on Monday Night Football. Second quarter of Monday Night Football, our season opener here in the new Meadowlands Stadium. Mike Tirico, John Gruden, Ron Jaworski up here in the booth. Jets leading 3-0, taking advantage of a red zone turnover by the Ravens, or they got the ball in the red zone after a Ravens turnover, and kicking a field goal for the only points. Shy midfield for second down, Mark Sanchez. Complete to the fullback, Tony Richardson. Takes it to the 47-yard line. So Richardson's been in the league 16 years and played 218 games. Right across from him, middle of the Ravens defense, Ray Lewis, regular season game 195, 15 years. Our visit with Ray, it was like it was week one, season one last night. So refreshing.
Well, incredible energy, passion for the game. That's what makes Ray Lewis so special. You know, he may have lost a step or two, but he makes up for that with decisiveness and recognition.
Brad Smith in the Wildcat formation. He's reading that and put it in the belly of Sean Green, who got popped by Lewis.
Right on call.
Well, the master of disaster was ready for the inside option. Take a look at him. Key the fullback, shoot his gun, and make a tackle. And when Ray Lewis hits you, you go sideways. You do not move the pile. Love watching this guy play.
And that's a super slow motion. You get the sense of how quick Green's body. And Green's a big fella now at 5'11", stout at 226. No forward progress. He was denied. So are the Jets on third down. Weatherford puts the nose down, hits that tumbling kick that is fair caught by Zbikowski at the 11. So in between the first and second quarter, Ray Lewis came over to get his ankle taped so he can get a quicker start out of the blocks.
And he got it.
Yes, he did. The Statue of Liberty over here on the Jersey side. Tonight's aerial coverage brought to you by DirecTV. Hey, look at Lady Liberty on this Monday night. Our game delayed starting by some 15 minutes because of a severe thunderstorm came through the area. Weather seems fine now. Jets nose tackle Chris Jenkins out for the rest of the game. Knee injury. Ray Rice runs to the left, takes it to the 18. John, tell me how Darrell Revis has been doing his first game back after the holdup.
Well, it's been a lot more of the same. You need some super glue. Hire Darrell Revis. He gets called for a penalty early, but he runs effortlessly with all kind of receivers all the time. Tight bump and run coverage on a fade. Good job pinning Bolden into the boundary. You can't have much better coverage than that, Josh.
Just call him Shade. All over you.
Rice is the back. Anquan Bolden in motion. Flacco, pressure up the middle. Got it to Heap. Spilled by Jim Leonard. Does a nice job at undersized safety. Third and two coming up. Can I ask you guys about Revis because of the holdout and all the money and who's the best corner and all this stuff. Deion Sanders was so elite because he shut down a side of the field. Is Revis that good?
Yes, he's that good.
Yeah, he is.
Deion taught me a long time ago, don't ever mess with me again. That guy, Darrell Revis, pick up any film you want, Mike. He throws one-hitters and no-hitters.
Jets fans on their feet. Third and a couple. With Heap back there to block. Didn't really get the block. And Thomas gets the sack. So the tight end Heap came over to be the help there. And erased by Brian Thomas.
Well, when you play in the backfield and you have blitz responsibility, you know, Todd Heap's got to come across this formation underneath Flacco in the shotgun. And he's got to make a flush pickup for Flacco to have a chance. The Jets are going to keep blitzing Joe Flacco, and they're going to keep covering his receivers with these talented corners. So far, a long night for Baltimore on offense.
But good coverage by Kyle Wilson and Anquan Bolden.
Sam Cooks, 50 years, the Ravens punter. Mike Westhoff's special teams usually do a great job for the Jets. Cook's kick is very good. 55 yards. Took Jim Leonard back to the 32. He got a great pocket as room. Leonard! Brought down by Cook, but in Ravens territory at the 37. Dwight Lowry made the big block that started the return for Leonard.
Well, Jim Leonard does so much for the New York Jets. Picks up a great block, and off to the races he goes. He has very good elusiveness and a lot more athletic ability than you think. Look at that hit.
Dwight Lowry on that block. Terrific. Now the move by Leonard. Mike Westhoff, special teams coach of the Jets, year in, year out, gets big plays out of teams.
If you went to the Jets facility and ran into Jim Leonard, you thought he's one of the guys who helps the coaching yeah. staff. He does not look like a football player, but he makes plays. He's undersized, but so smart.
Yeah. Plug a tape in. You'll see plays.
Yeah. Jets showing different formations here. Awesome. A penalty on Braylon Edwards. He wasn't set. Keller down the seam. Caught it. It's at the four, but a flag is down at the line of scrimmage. When they were messing around the formation, Edwards never got set. It'll cost them.
Well, when you shift your offensive players, that can be a good thing to confuse the defense. But when you shift, you have to be set for a full count.
Illegal shift, number 17, offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
John, say what you want. That is inexcusable. You get in these situations, you'll see Braylon Edwards, number 17. They're trying to set him up for that one-on-one against Fabian Washington. Just set yourself when you get out there.
Well, they tried to use a quick count after a shift. And part of that's on the quarterback, too, Ron. You got to give your guys a chance to get set. Costly penalty.
Erasing a gain of 33. Timeout by Sanchez, trying to use the hard count to force the Ravens offside. They've been down this block before. They weren't buying. Timeout, Jets. Rex Ryan, whose dad, Buddy Ryan, was part of the Jets staff when Weave Eubank was the head coach when the Jets were victorious in Super Bowl III. And trying to bring the Jets back to prominence. Certainly have been the winners of the offseason in terms of headlines. They set an NFL record for most summer headlines, and now see if they can back it up. Leading 3-0 against Ray Lewis and the Ravens here in the second quarter of the opener.
Read it, punt. Kill. Nut.
Double.
Look at team. Look good.
From the 42, Sean Green, a run to the right, gets it to the 35. And a flag comes down as he is brought down by a face mask, so that'll take it right to the edge, or if not, into the red zone.
No way!
Personal foul, horse collar tackle, horse number collar. 53, defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
On Jamil McClain, we heard kill, Mark Sanchez, the quarterback, saying that, getting them into the right play.
Well, the Jets do a lot of that, as you see the horse collar. There's no question about the call right there. But the Jets are doing a lot before the ball is snapped. They call a play in the huddle. They kill it with another play. If they don't get the look they want, they kill it to a better play. And Mark Sanchez, for a young quarterback, is doing a very good job keeping the Jets in good play selection.
They haven't called Jericho Cotchery's name yet. He's at the top of the screen. Green runs right. Sean gains about two-thirds of the Jets' carries last year in the backfield were Thomas Jones or Leon Washington. Now the change with Sean Green, who proved himself in the playoffs, and LaDainian Tomlinson.
Why wouldn't they change? I mean, they changed Brett Favre for Sanchez. They got rid of Jonathan Vilma. They bring in Bart Scott. You get rid of a 1,400-yard back and a Pro Bowl left guard, they must feel like they have something here in Sean Green. He did have over 300 yards in three playoff games.
Tomlinson's now the running back, and a whistle.
False start, number 60, offense. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
It's on DeBrickashaw Ferguson, the left tackle.
But you know, when you do all these dummy counts and you try to call the perfect play all the time, put yourself in DeBrickashaw Ferguson's position. You got one play called in the huddle, you got it killed with another play, and I got to block Terrell Suggs by myself. It's hard on these linemen. Penalty right there. You can understand why sometimes.
You're thinking pass, all of a sudden they kill it and go to run. Change your stance. Checking again.
And Tomlinson running to the left. That new left guard slots it over there. But Tavares Gooden makes the stop. It'll be third down for the Jets.
You know, Mike, everyone's going to talk about, you know, where is Sanchez in his growth? What's he going to do better his second year? I think we're beginning to see that. Commanding the offense, knowing when to audible, knowing not to audible, getting into the right look, throwing against the right coverage. You're seeing that growth here tonight in Mark Sanchez. The one big throw he made was negated by the penalty, but so far so good for Sanchez.
Jets have failed on third and four twice. They failed on third and eight. Sanchez going to run for it and slide it. It's where you start your slide, not where you're a touch. So it's at the 10, going to be a yard shy of the first down. And in a game where scoring will be at a premium, let's see what Rex does.
Well, you got to be concerned about this judgment on Mark Sanchez.
Well, look, it's a three-man rush. It's a three-man rush against an empty backfield set, so the Ravens have eight in coverage. And Mark Sanchez does the right thing. There's nobody open. He scrambles, and it sets up a big one right here, Mike.
John, I agree with the scramble. When you know you've got a half a yard to get that first down, there comes a time when you've got to sell out. You've got to know where the stakes are and go for the first down.
Well, Rex has the flag. First and taking the timeout, maybe thinking about a challenge to see where the slide started and check the spot. Okay, a few bits of business. We looked at it during the timeout. The ball was very well spotted.
These referees are getting tired of all the post-snap fisticuffs going on. The referees are just letting both teams know that's it.
So Rex Ryan's team off to kick off from the 15-yard line. Instead of the 30, Jalen Parmalee back to receive. It's a Jet team that has made lots of news here in this offseason with their bravado, their attitude. And on the back pages a lot in New York. In the summer. Parmalee has it at the 18. In good field position for the Ravens as he's brought down at the 36. But the Jets were on the back pages and front pages for a very different reason today. Michelle Tafoya has more.
Yeah, Mike, there have been allegations of inappropriate behavior by some of the Jets players and coaches toward a female sports reporter from Azteca TV, which is a Mexican television station. Now, that reporter has not filed any formal complaint, but both the NFL and the Jets have been proactive. I spoke with NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell and Jets GM Mike Tannenbaum. They are conducting a joint investigation into these allegations. And again, while a formal complaint has not been filed, they're looking to see if any policies have been violated, Mike.
Okay, Michelle, there's the commissioner who was here yesterday for the Giants opener as well. You see Roger there with George Bodenheimer, our president at ESPN. From the 36, a run for Rice, gains nothing. Sean Ellis with the stop. And just one more point on that. Michelle was talking about, you saw Woody Johnson, the chairman and CEO of the Jets. He called the reporter who was involved in this story yesterday to have a conversation directly with her. So we'll follow that investigation as that goes forward over the next few days.
Well, the Ravens have tried this unbalanced line a couple times, and they have been rejected, Jaws.
Yep.
All three times they've done it. They've got to have success on first down to give them a chance. These long yardage situations are impossible against New York.
So is running the ball tonight. They're getting nothing out of the run game. Play clock running down now on Flacco. Everybody picked up for a second. Flacco throws incomplete, trying to throw for Bolden with the rookie Kyle Wilson on him. But Brian Thomas continues to bring good pressure tonight for the Jets.
Well, they had something working over there against the rookie Kyle Wilson. Take a look at Anquan Bolden on a little double move on the outside. Here he is in the slot. They get a little quick screen. They fake it to Todd Heap, and up goes Bolden. I'm surprised Flacco missed that one.
Yeah, they had a little rub, and it worked, and Hugh got open, and Joe missed him.
Third and nine. We'll see if the Jets bring pressure. Five come. Flacco puts it up for Mason, who tries to come back on Cromartie and draws a penalty flag on Antonio.
That's what I've been waiting for all night. You see this bump and run, tight coverage. You got a big arm quarterback. Let them rip it. And they go right after Antonio Cromartie.
You'll see the play right here. Mason, the ball slightly underthrown, but Cromartie whacks his hands before the ball gets there. That is interference. John, you mentioned it during the break. We were talking about that. You cannot allow a corner to get in your face, bump and run, and take you away without challenging him.
So, guys, the Ravens have converted third and nine and third and 13 on their own so far, and third and 28 and 39 because of Jets penalties. And usually, as Jaws said, as Rice carries for a yard, that's the disaster down against this Rex Ryan defense, third and six or seven or more.
Yeah, but I go back to Derek Mason, Anquan Bolden, Hushman Zada, these veteran receivers. A lot of people say they can't run, they can't stretch the field. Derek Mason just won big time at the line of scrimmage. He knows how to change speeds. He can set people up. Look for them to continue to find opportunities deep with double moves.
That vertical threat, they hope they'll get back when Dante Stallworth comes back from an injury he suffered in the preseason. They hope to have Stallworth back in October. Flacco's pass is knocked down by the rookie Kyle Wilson. It was intended for Hushmanzada. And this guy from Boise State is not afraid. He's getting tested, too.
There's no question that the Ravens are going after Kyle Wilson. But the defense, the Jets right now, has Flacco a little bit confused. He's about 2/10, 3/10 of a second late getting the ball out of his hand because he's not seeing the field clearly right now. He's got to pick up his pace and his tempo. I wouldn't be surprised the next series to see the Ravens come out in a little speed, no huddle offense. Their tempo is very sluggish right now.
3rd and 9. Who's coming? They're all picked up. And the pass is caught by Mason. That was a shot right in front of Cromartie again. But Mason hangs on, first down, Baltimore.
You know, when you watch Derek Mason play the game, the bigger the game, the better the corner, the better he plays. This is tight bump and run coverage. Mason gets on top of Cromartie and gets out of his break with ease. And that ball was in on Mason as soon as he turned. What a great catch and great route by Derek Mason.
How about the throw, John? Get the quarterback now.
From the 22. Flacco gives to Ray Rice. Gains about 2 yards. So, you're talking about veteran receivers, John, and Mason and Bolden, Hushmanzada brought over. It's the first time you've had 3 wide receivers in NFL history on the same team with 500 or more catches. Now you got to manage them all.
Well, these guys can line up in any formation. These 3 guys can run the route. These guys will go.
And all 3
intercepted and brought out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
Taylor gets one. And
great electrifying returns. Now my team and the Jets 11 at the 31. This play has been challenged by Baltimore. Walt Anderson is looking to see if Antonio Cromartie stayed in bounds. We showed you on the look before the break. We believe he's in bounds all the way through. And this man is an electric return guy. Remember that 109-yard missed field goal he brought back in Minnesota for a touchdown? The longest play in NFL history? Big one there.
How about Darrell Revis? Oof. When the Jets intercept the ball or a return and a fumble, they are vicious blockers for each other. I mean, Revis came from nowhere and dropped the house on Bolden.
Walt Anderson, the referee.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the Ravens and the Jets both down to 1 timeout.
Well, I got to think that Anquan Bolden is supposed to run a post and clear it out for Heap, who's running a flat and up. But Anquan looked like he stopped to the inside. They don't get the corner cleared out, Jaws. And that's just easy pickings for Cromartie. I would expect Flacco to see that and throw it away. But they're clearly not on the same page there.
Cromartie, who had really lost a lot of the ability and trust in San Diego, leaving there, traded for what can be a 3rd-round pick coming here to the Jets. Makes an impact in his first game for New York. From the 31, here's Sanchez. There's the first catch for Jericho Cotchery. Gain of 5 to the 26. In front of Chris Carr, you have Cotchery, who has led the Jets in receptions and yards the last 3 years. What has happened tonight has been the Jets' defense. Very first play of the season for the Ravens. Flacco fumbles. David Harris knocked this one out. Both recovered by Sione Puua. And now the turnover as Flacco's intercepted by Antonio Cromartie. So the Ravens' offense tonight, in addition to those 3 turnovers, 25 plays and 67 yards. Explains where we are at 6-0 here in the second. Green lost the ball. And it belongs to Baltimore. Sean Green, who had 3 lost fumbles in his first 70 carries early on, as we have a collection of offensive and defensive players out there as we watch the fumble with Green, who bumped into Matt Slauson, his offensive lineman.
Well, he just got to wrap that up. He does run into Matt Slauson, but you got to secure that ball. Looked like he had 2 hands wrapped around it. It squeezed out.
Yeah, but the 2 things you have to do if you're going to become a feature back in this league, you have to be durable, and you got to take care of the ball.
Recovered by the defense. First down.
Remember, it's two fumbles tonight for Green. One went out of bounds that he fumbled. But your point's well taken with veteran guys who take care of the ball.
The Ravens just need to settle down. I still think all three turnovers, they've put upon themselves. They've held the ball too long. They haven't taken care of it. They've made some bad decisions. Flacco needs to get something going here before the half.
Well, here's their cluster bunch formation. The Flacco's left. This is a good way to break down that secondary. It likes to get in that press coverage. Rosado goes in motion.
And Flacco from the 24. Jaws runs Rice, who stumbles forward and gains 5 to the 29.
One of the things with Ray Rice is he's 5'8", and that might be being generous. He is very thick and quick, and from a linebacker's perspective, you can't find Ray Rice. He slithers and slides behind these big offensive guards, and he's a very decisive, compact runner and a heck of a finisher.
And this Jets defense without Chris Jenkins, injured his knee in the first quarter. Nose tackle out for the remainder of the game. Who knows how long he'll be out. A gun run with Rice to be 3 yards shy of the first down. And SportsCenter right now comes right now with Trey Wingo.
All right, Michael, thank you. On ESPN2, U.S. Open men's final, Rafa Nadal lost the second set to Novak Djokovic. That's the first set he's dropped all tournament long. They are in the third set right now. Now, don't forget, coming up at 10:15 on ESPN2, Phillip Rivers and the Chargers getting set to start their season in Kansas City in the best-smelling stadium in the world against the Chiefs. That's at 10:15 on ESPN2. Let's go back to Mike Tirico.
All right, great night. So it'll start over there, come on over here when the game is done between the Ravens and the Jets. 3rd and 3. Flacco, pressure, got rid of it for Hushman Zana, caught at the 42, first down. Big time play by Flacco and a gain of 27.
Well, they get instant pressure off of Flacco's right side. The Jets bring a lot of people into the football game that don't play defensive line, and they bring DBs and linebackers from everywhere. Great job of Flacco getting rid of it on time.
This is the key right here. Identify the single man-to-man coverage. You've got a tall receiver like Hujman Zada at 6'2" that can leap and go up and take it away.
James Ahedebo was the safety who got there a second late. Flacco throws again. Hushman Zada was tangled with Cromartie. And another flag is down in the secondary.
Well, Antonio Cromartie is target number one in this second quarter. That's clearly pass interference.
Holy, number 31, defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Take a look at Hushman Zada. He gets grabbed at the top of the route. They're going to see that every time. Antonio is one of the tallest, rangiest corners in the league. Sometimes he has a hard time getting in and out of his break. They're going after him right now.
And, John, they're getting him out of his comfort level. He likes to play that right cornerback spot in that press bail technique. You move him in the slot, you give a two-way go for that receiver, inside or outside. He struggles in that position.
Flacco. Oh, he almost threw it right into Jason Taylor's stomach, just trying to get rid of it. It's Brian Thomas, who already has a sack and a half tonight, was closing in on another one.
You know, one of the things the Jets do defensively, if you just look out there, they've got one defensive lineman on the field.
Yeah.
That's number 92, Sean Ellis. Everybody else is a linebacker or a defensive back, and it's hard for offenses to recognize who's who. Confusion is a big part of this Jets defense.
The Jets love that small ball. A lot of safeties and corners on the field. Speed and quickness. Attack the quarterback. You're going to get it here.
Here comes the pressure from Leonard. Mason catches underneath, takes a shot, but hangs on. And Derek Mason very close to a first down as we dip under the two-minute warning. Man, for a 6-0 game, there is a lot going on. Exactly what we expected from the Jets and the Ravens. Chris Berman, Toyota Halftime Show coming up. If you took Arian Foster in your fantasy draft, you liking yourself right now? We'll talk about the Texans runner. Chris Johnson, a little sports science behind the guy who had 142 yards yesterday. And Green Day performs at the half. Ravens have it 3rd and a long yard. And McGay's not going to get it. Let's see what Baltimore will do here with a field goal 44, 45 yards.
Once again, the Jets playing that overload heavy front. They are stopping it every single time.
Field goal. I love when it's third and one and you don't get it, and the guy was carrying it. He said, come on, let's go for it again. Sorry, too late.
You had your chance.
Peace.
You got to credit the Jets. They have just rocked this Raven running game. And you would think LaRon McClain behind these offensive guards would be able to pick up a yard.
46-yard field goal. Billy Cundiff, play clock running down. He beat Shane Graham in a preseason kicking battle to win the job. Jet got through nearly at a block, but Cundiff pounds it.
Penalty
from 46. A penalty marker is down. Penalty marker is down, so let's check out what that call is. It is fourth and a yard, so.
Running into the kicker, number 17 of the defense.
Braylon Edwards.
Did not let the kicker get his kicking leg to the ground. It's a 5-yard penalty, and it's first down.
Keeps the drive alive. He'll take the points off the board. Braylon Edwards, special teams.
Well, Mike Westhoff told us he was going to use Braylon Edwards in the kicking game to block a kick. He came through clean. I don't know about this.
Again, it's the same thing like the Lions play. The rule is, you may not like the rule, but the call is correct, and Walt Anderson did a great job of explaining, you've got to let the kicker have some place to bring his leg down. It's a 5-yard penalty. First down. Don't look at me like that, Drew. I didn't write the book. I'm just learning it. Fourth first down by penalty against the Jets. Keeps the drive alive. And Usmanzada is covered by Revis, incomplete. Again,
you make the call at home. I mean, this is almost like giving a guy a traffic ticket in a 30-mile-an-hour zone for going 31 miles an hour. Give me a break. I don't like that call, Jaws. I just think that's ticky-tack.
You don't like any calls, but how about Braylon Edwards using his defensive tackle there to jump over, pull his jersey, get over the top?
We're not
talking about that.
Well, let's see what the Ravens do with it, because they took points off the board here. Which in a game yesterday, we saw somebody take points off the board and not be able to get it. Last night for the Redskins and Cowboys. Flacco for Usmanzada. Incomplete. Covered by Cromartie. Third down coming.
Joe Flacco looking at that matchup right now, and he gets Usmanzada on Cromartie, trying to take advantage of that. Here you see a little bail technique by Cromartie. Throw this ball inbounds. Joe, you got a shot at it, but Cromartie in very good position. Really gave Joe a small window to throw that one into, and Flacco threw it out of bounds.
Antonio Cromartie has not seen this much work ever.
He saw Peyton Manning a few times.
They've been awful on every down but third and long. Play clock just beat it. Everybody's picked up. Flacco takes a shot for the Usmanzada end zone run, and it brings a flag on the rookie, Kyle Wilson. It'll be first and goal if it's called pass interference, not holding.
One thing about Rex Ryan, he will bring the heat no matter what situation. You're going to get Kyle Wilson, the rookie, matched up on Usmanzada. Flacco recognizes the matchup, sees the one-on-one, zero coverage, no in the middle of the field, take your shot. He gets the penalty called against Kyle Wilson.
Well, that's a gutsy call. All out, zero blitz. You put your rookie corner one-on-one. That's what you're doing to your rookie corner when you full blitz. Good call by the ref.
Ravens bring Haloti Ngata in to help out and lead the way for McGahee down here at the goal line. There goes Willis toward the goal line, but not in. 44 seconds left. Ravens have a timeout. So Ngata, the all-pro defensive lineman in there. Eric Smith starting for Brodney Poole at free safety made the tackle.
Now I'm sitting up here in the booth a long way from this play, but if I'm Willis McGahee, when you see this little seam right there, burrow your shoulder down and drive that thing to the goal line. A little bit too upright, he's going to get knocked backwards.
Ngata now moves up to the left tackle spot, essentially. It's play action, and Flacco has a wide open McClain, and he overthrew him. Oh, brother.
But McGahee made up for maybe not scoring on first down. What a great block by Willis McGahee, number 23. This is fire protection. You'll see a quick fake inside. He's got to pick it up quick because there's going to be pressure. And Joe Flacco just flat out missed LaRon McClain.
joint is jumping. Third down. McGahee powers it in. Touchdown, Baltimore.
That's the red zone closing finish of Willis McGahee that you expect. He had 14 touchdowns last year for this Raven offense. Here he is bursting off the left side. He sees just a crack. Get your shoulders square, Willis McGahee, and drive it across the goal line. Big score for the Ravens.
Nice job by LaRon McClain, seeing the inside pressure, getting a chip, just giving a little bit of a seam for Willis McGahee.
The edge to try to get there for the block. Didn't. 7-6 Ravens. They finally scored. Be right back. One of the big stories of last year for the Baltimore Ravens in their 9-7 wild card season, won at New England, lost to Indianapolis with penalties. 1,094 penalty yards, the most penalty yards in the NFL. Well, Raven fans have to feel like, finally, after all we endured last year, somebody else is doing what we do. The Jets have been penalized 9 times for 95 yards in the first half, and the running into the kicker and the pass interference allowed the Ravens to score the touchdown to take the lead. 5-yard penalty after the kick. Hundiff kicks it all the way to Brad Smith, 5 yards deep. He'll take a knee.
Well, here's the touchdown. Just a simple off-tackle run to the left side of the formation. Here you're going to see McGahee take the ball from Flacco and just press it to the line of scrimmage. He bounces it. And when you bounce it outside, Jaws, you're on your own. Just a nice finish by a big 240-pound Willis McGahee.
Boy, Mike, you mentioned those penalties. 9 penalties. You know, you just look at it week in and week out. Teams that turn the football over and get penalties, they lose football games. Don't beat yourself. Right now, the Jets are behind because of their self-inflicted wounds.
Oh, well, the Jets just got a 10th penalty.
Man in the offensive huddle. 5-yard penalty. First down.
I mean, it's 6 seconds left. Did you watch the Cowboys last night? You should be taking a knee and getting out of Dodge, and they messed that one up. So 10 penalties here. Still not a Jet record for penalties in a first half. They had, the last time they had this many, they had 12 penalties in the first half of an 0-4 game against the Steelers. Yeah, they take a knee, take it to the locker room, and the Ravens will get the ball to start the second half. Baltimore's 3 turnovers turned into 3 Jet points. The Jets turnover turns into a touchdown. It's 7-6 Ravens, and here's Chris Berman, the Hall of Famer, with the Toyota Halftime Show.
You're too kind, Michael. Thank you.
Get the ball first to start the third quarter here at the new Meadowlands. See if Mark Sanchez and this team can get some offense moving. Just 4 of 7 for 23 first half yards. Nick Folk will kick the pyrotechnics after the Green Day concert. Has left a whiteout in the sky. So the ball tumbles through the sky toward Jalen Parmalee, but instead it is Zivikowski who makes the catch at the 11, and the punt returner Zivikowski is brought down by Brad Smith at the 28. See the fighting there. We go to Michelle Tafoya on the sideline.
Well, Mike, I spoke with Rex Ryan as he came back out onto the field, and in particular those 10 penalties for 100 yards you just mentioned. He said there are aggressive penalties and there are dumb penalties. We got to eliminate the dumb penalties and we'll be just fine. And in particular, he pointed out Antonio Cromartie, who had a couple of big ones there. And he said he's got to step up, continue to be aggressive, but play like we're supposed to play, Mike.
All right, Michelle, thanks. Cromartie and Kyle Wilson, 2 cornerbacks who have been inserted into this defense where you're asked very often to play man-to-man.
Well, if you play man-to-man and Darrell Revis is on your team, they're not throwing at Revis. They're going to throw at Wilson and Cromartie again in this second half.
Drive starts for Flacco and the Ravens from the 28. Flacco rolls for time and checks it down to LaRon McClain. Gets about 5 to the 33-yard line.
Penalties are unforgivable. You'll see Cromartie here. He's in good position right there, but you've got to locate the football. He did not. Darrell Revis can't make this play. You're in good position on the coverage. Don't grab the jersey. 3rd and long. Now you'll see Kyle Wilson. 0 coverage. Get back there. Don't grab the arm. three bad penalties by the Jets secondary.
Second and five, second throw of the half for Flacco. Look out. David Harris was tied up with Heap in coverage, and Sean Ellis was the one who was pressuring Flacco. Here are the numbers in the first half. Jets had 16 more penalty yards than total yards. The Ravens with 12 first downs. The Jets had one by run, one by pass, and one by penalty. And Baltimore's been able to sustain, guys. Six conversions, a few helped by penalty.
And the Jets have not capitalized with the three turnovers that they created on defense.
They're going to get Huzmanzada on Cromartie down here in single coverage.
Flacco throws underneath. That's a Heap. He stops and stretches. Bart Scott hits him. But all doesn't matter. First down, Baltimore, as Heap, who's in his 10th year now in the league, twice to the Pro Bowl, continues to play at a high level.
You're going to get the man-to-man coverage. You got right here Smith on Heap, quick to the outside. As Smith is looking in the backfield, easy first down. When you bring pressure, it's single coverage on the outside. The quarterback has to identify quickly. Flacco did, got the ball out of his hand.
Run up the middle for a couple of yards with Mike DeVito coming in for the tackle on Ray Rice. We should remind you, if you're just joining us, Chris Jenkins injured his knee in the first quarter at the point of the Jets' defense, so critical, out for the rest of the game, who knows how long.
And that hurts the Jets. And I've seen Rex Ryan call three snaps of zone coverage already here in the third quarter. That's one way that you stay away from pass interference. Yeah. Don't call any more man-to-man coverages. Let these corners have a break, settle in a little bit to the game here as we start the third quarter.
Play action, Mason running to the right. Flacco going to Derek Mason. Incomplete as Cromartie stumbled chasing after Mason. Fans want it.
Well, it's great pass protection, and you'll see Mason in short motion. Watch him sell this to the outside and then take off. Had a step, but great recoverability by Antonio Cromartie. This guy, Derek Mason, is dangerous on the double moves down the field. And that's the area, Jaws, that Flacco wanted to improve greatly was the vertical passing game.
And I like the motion, so you can't get that jam, can't get that bump. They got Mason motion, so he can get a clean release on Cromartie. Once you get Bolden in motion.
And again, the Jets, one down lineman, and Jason Taylor is hand down too. Flacco pressure, got rid of it. Rice couldn't haul it in. And after a first down, Baltimore will be forced to punt on their second set of downs.
Well, the Ravens picked up the blitz. Bart Scott finally got free at the end. There's just nobody open to throw the football to. The blitz pickup is good enough. You can't hold the ball forever against this secondary. Good coverage by New York.
Kyle Wilson, the rookie, who was a good kick returner at Boise State, comes in now to return punts for the Jets. Not a good kick from Cook. Wilson took it on the run to the 23. He's brought down to the 30 by David Reed. You want the training wheels off? See if put the screwdriver to the old bicycle at halftime. See what the Jets got when you come back. On the west side, but once the Olympic bid for the New York City area fell apart, and that didn't happen, we're working in partnership with the Giants to build this new Meadowlands Stadium. Both teams opening back-to-back days of the regular season. Drive starts on the 31. Tomlinson's the back. It's play action there. And a throw to LT. Gain of about eight near the 39-yard line.
Mike, you talked about taking the training wheels off. Sanchez went play action here. I believe he had Braylon Edwards open on the turn up top screen. However, when he looks, he gets so ingrained to check down, check down, check down, he didn't let the play develop down the field.
Ravens showing a little different look for Tomlinson, tied up by Haloti Ngata. Third down coming up. Brian Schottenheimer is the offensive coordinator for the Jets. Fifth season, that job, son of a terrific head coach in the NFL, Marty Schottenheimer, who's here tonight. Brian, in his playing days in college, backed up Danny Werfel when Florida won the national title. He's trying to get his young quarterback now in his second year to make a big leap here this year.
Evening, my 5-6. Line, line.
They haven't picked up a third down tonight.
Read it hard.
Come on, man.
Reach it clean. Reach cut.
They'll throw on third and short and take a shot for Kotchery. No shot. Fans want a flag. Although Chris Carr's coverage is pretty good, freeing out the Jets.
Well, the Jets are doing more before the ball is snapped than any team I've seen in a while. A lot of dummy counts, trying to get in the right play. They finally get one-on-one coverage, and they take a shot with Jericho Kotchery. And Carr does a nice job pinning them into the boundary. There's just no chance for Jericho to make a play there. I always told our quarterbacks, if you make the decision to throw it deep, give our guy a chance to make a play on it.
Watch out for Brad Smith. He's a backup quarterback. He can sneak in there and take a snap. He's right up there around the center. A fourth and short, just playing personal protector here. Weatherford gets off a line drive kick, 47 yards. Zivikowski with a flag down, comes down to the 25. Josh Wilson, who they just picked up from Seattle, was over there blocking, and it was the direction of the flag. Walt Anderson has been busy, as is usual for Walt.
During the kick, holding number 37 of the receiving team, half the distance to the goal from the end of the kick, the first down, timeout.
So a long field coming for the Ravens. You know how you coaches like to script your first 15 plays?
Yeah.
Glad the Jets worked on, because they've only run 23. We're here in the third quarter. There's more to come. Three and a half gone here in the third quarter. Maybe the Jets defense is going to have to get the points. We're down at Fireman Edge End, the legendary Jet fan from the 7. Flacco gives to Ray Rice, the former Rutgers running back. He's pulled down by Eric Smith, the safety. Gain of 4.
Now, this is their best play out of that heavy formation where they overload to the left.
Well, they've got three tight ends, really two tight ends, and McClain playing the wing right here. And you'll see Flacco just reverse pivot, hand the ball on a zone blocking play to Ray Rice, and let him slip and slide. Nice finish by Ray Rice. That's a good run when you're backed up in this field position.
After a gain of 3, Flacco throws for Bolden. Incomplete. Smith the safety, Bart Scott the linebacker cover.
And one of the things that the Ravens are doing by getting into these multiple tight end sets is to try to reduce the pressure of the Jet defense.
Flag down back by the quarterback. Illegal use of hands. Rex going to push him back or decline. Decline, yeah, absolutely.
Illegal hands, hands to the face, number 73, offense. The penalty is declined. It's third down.
From Marshall Yanda. He's moved over to right tackle tonight. It's going to get loud down at this end for third down.
Normally tough downs against this Jets defense. This is when they really mix up their fronts, their looks, and bring pressure.
Ravens got to hurry. This clock is nearing 10 seconds.
Timeout, Baltimore.
Wow.
They'll be even louder when you come back. Chant that started Shea Stadium when the Jets were at home there. They moved over in the parking lot when Giant Stadium stood, and is reverberating around the new Meadowlands Stadium. Ravens have been good on third down. This is 3rd and 7. Vernon Golston, 50. Jets first round pick a couple years ago. Dropping in coverage. Flacco throws deep for Bolden, who has it on the rookie Wilson. Out to midfield. A first down gain of 39.
Once again, the Jets bring their pressure. They're going to single up their secondary, man-to-man. You get Kyle Wilson on Anquan Boldin, who is big, strong. He's physical. Here comes the pressure. No one in the middle of the field. You've got the man-to-man coverage. Boldin, you'll see, wins quickly. He just runs by Kyle Wilson. Flacco lays the ball up perfectly for Anquan Boldin.
Yeah, but you're asking a lot of Kyle Wilson. This is his first game in the National Football League. He's running everywhere.
He's a rookie.
Zada and then Boldin.
He's a rookie. There's a star on him. They're going after him.
From the 49, up the middle with Rice across midfield into Jets territory at the 47. Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator for Baltimore, has a lot of options now with these guys. And we talked about adding Anquan Boldin, getting him from Arizona. What can he do to an offense? You've seen so much of that tonight.
Yeah, but he also told us, look, we have a shot at a rookie playing his first game, and we will go after Kyle Wilson repeatedly. Yep. And Cam Cameron coached in San Diego when Cromartie was there with him, so he probably knows more about Antonio Cromartie than we do. And he is clearly going after Kyle Wilson and Antonio Cromartie.
He has a good understanding of Rex Ryan's defensive mindset as well. Run with Rice, flag down as he's down at the 44-yard line. Check this flag.
They're going to get Jason Taylor for offsides here.
Offside, number 99, defense, 5-yard penalty. It's still second down.
Let's talk about that for a second. All right, Josh, you go ahead.
Yeah, when you have a Kyle Wilson, as John just alluded to, a rookie, you're going to go after him. He's got the star. Here, Todd, he dropped this one. Should have been a touchdown. Now here you got Husmanzada running by him. Well, he's grabbing, he's clutching. They're going to get that called all the time. Single coverage, no help. Here on Anquan Boldin, no one in the middle of the field to help. Anquan's just too big, too strong. Out leaps Kyle Wilson and takes it away. They will continue to put pressure on Wilson if he gets in those man-on-man situations.
Now second and short for Flacco. Working on Wilson again. Boldin brings it in again.
That's what Anquan Boldin brings to the table. Kyle Wilson again has Anquan Boldin. He has good coverage. But when you play against a guy like Joe Flacco who can make all the throws, and Flacco's confident in a guy like Boldin, he'll go up and get it. That's an outstanding throw, back shoulder fade, and good elevation by Anquan Boldin. He is in a zone right now.
That's just tremendous trust by Joe Flacco that Anquan can go up and grab it.
Gains of 38 and 27 to Boldin on Wilson in this drive. Rice, 4 to the 11-yard line. A flag is down. This could come back for an offensive hold.
I don't think we've had back-to-back plays run tonight without a penalty.
There is no flag for offensive holding. It's second down.
Okay, then why did he throw the flag?
It looked like Brian Thomas got hooked. Thankfully, the flag was picked up.
You kind of get a sense that Cam Cameron now is getting a rhythm from what the Jets defense is trying to do. He's dialing up the right plays on this drive.
He's throwing it to Boldin against man-to-man coverage.
While well, he's getting the field.
Empty backfield. And Flacco underneath with Rice, who caught 78 balls to lead NFL running backs in receptions last year. You guys talk about Boldin. Twice on this drive, we've seen him catch passes that were thrown to a target downfield, being Boldin more than 21 yards in the air. He only did that once last year. All those receptions with Kurt Warner at Atlanta behind the line of scrimmage or in that shorter area. So going a little bit farther downfield, a little bit different from what we've seen recently of Boldin.
Well, he signed with the Ravens for a reason. He's seen Joe Flacco on TV humming it. Here's a great opportunity for Flacco to look for his new acquisition.
Boldin covered by the rookie from Boise State, Wilson again. Flacco comes to this side to Rice, who couldn't hold on, as David Harris had the coverage. And we'll get a field goal opportunity for Baltimore.
Well, this is one of those plays. You get the matchup you want. You got Ray Rice on a little angle route against David Harris. Joe just got to put this one on the belt buckle. He threw it low. Rice had to stop an incompletion. That's the matchup you want to get. This is a good matchup. Joe just throws this one down in the ground. You got to put it on the numbers.
Yeah, but keep an eye on Braylon Edwards right here. He came right up the middle last time, yep. Number 17, almost blocked a kick.
Cundiff from 25 yards. Edwards just leaping that time, didn't spring over the lineman. And Cundiff pounds it through. So the Ravens at a field goal have what feels like an insurmountable four-point lead. Both of these coaches lost the AFC Championship game in their rookie year. It's a pretty tall accomplishment to get there. John Harbaugh, who got the Baltimore job after Rex Ryan did not. Rex was the defensive coordinator, popular in the locker room, interviewed a couple of times. When it became clear he wasn't going to get the job, Harbaugh got late in the process and became the candidate, and they spoke, and he said, Rex, I'd love to have you stay and be the defensive coordinator. He was, did a very good job with that defense. They got to the conference championship game, lost to Pittsburgh, and then Rex Ryan got the Jets job and lost to Indianapolis on the game before the Super Bowl. Brad Smith returns for the Jets out to the 32-yard line. You know what I like about both guys, too? Football is the family for them. You know, Jack Harbaugh, John's dad, a great collegiate coach for many years. Jim Harbaugh, John's brother, very good NFL quarterback, doing a great job at Stanford. They're off to a really good start. And, of course, Rob Ryan, the brother of Rex Ryan's, the defensive coordinator in Cleveland, and you had a Ryan in your life as well.
Oh, yeah. I had Buddy Ryan, you know, played against Buddy's defense, played with him in Philadelphia. And I tell you what, same style. Get after the quarterback.
Football, so much of the family DNA for both of these guys here tonight. From the 32-yard line, here's Tomlinson with a run for about 5 to the 37.
Seeing a lot of LaDainian Tomlinson. Sean Green, two fumbles tonight. Really hasn't played much, Jaws, since. But the Jets have got to get something going. They got to get this crowd in the game. Four first downs, less than 100 yards of offense. You can play all the defense you want, but you've got to play some offense. It's a key possession for New York.
Wow. 23 plays. From the 37, here's LT going left. It's to the 40. It's going to be third and about 2 yards. Remember, this was ground and pound. They ran it more and better than everyone in the NFL last year.
Yeah, well, the Ravens play run defense.
Really?
More and better than just about anybody for the last decade.
Yeah, they gave up 3.4 yards per attempt a year ago. That's darn good defense. That front seven is tough to move. And remember, you got Matt Slauson at left guard for the Jets, replacing Alan Faneca. Slauson, his first start tonight.
3-20. Strike. Third and two. Tomlinson. Ray Lewis pushed Richardson back into the backfield. Blew the play up. Three and out. And the Jets fans not happy.
Well, you're trying to get the crowd into the game for the Jets. This play calling is getting them against the Jets.
Well, Ray Lewis sees it all the way. Runs right through there. Forces the back to cut back. The Ravens play run defense. Kind of like, I don't know. What do you do good, Rob?
like
nothing?
But golf. They do. I golf well, John.
They play run defense as good as any team in football.
It's the only guy without his name on his bag who says I golf well. It's incredible. Oh, my. Struggles continue here for the Jets. Weatherford to punt. Zbikowski going to go back and field it at the 5. A 56-yard punt. Going to pick up a block here. Be careful of a safety. Was the ball outside? Did the ball come out? It's ruled at forward progress there at the 1. The Jets are saying touchdown. James Ahedebo came in to hit Zbikowski. And that was very dangerous. Usually they tell you don't field it inside the 10. But with these punts that are going end over end, a lot of guys are fielding it even closer because it's going to go down at the 5 or less. Now let's see what happens to the ball.
Yeah, but Mike, in a game like this, don't catch it at the 5-yard line and run into your own end zone and then cough the ball up.
He looked to be down before the ball came out, but let's get a look here. He's down there. His knee is down. He still has the ball. And on the first look we saw, it looked like the ball was outside of the goal line.
That's what happens when you get injuries. Ladarius Webb, their former one of their key return guys is out. Ed Reed has done that for a while. But Zivakowski clearly has to use better judgment. Putting your offense in this situation, in like this crowd noise, is not good.
That looks like a good call. The ball is outside of the goal line there as his knee comes down. And it was not a fumble. So the Jets choosing not to challenge. They saw the replays. You did. John points to the crowd, 99 yards away. Flacco for about a quarter of a yard. We have max zoom this year. We have 32 cameras located around the goal lines and the sidelines here. We can zoom in and watch. So you're going to see where the ball is when his knee comes down in that shin. And on that max zoom, which really got you in close there, you could see the ball was on the good side for Baltimore of the plane of the end zone. So the call was very well done by the official down there to call that line.
Once again, that heavy formation to the left, the Ravens offensive line. You got to expect they're going to run left.
McGahee is the back going that way. He gets out of the end zone, doesn't get back to the line, and we'll have third and about 10.
I guess the Jets anticipated that run to the left with the overload heavy front on that side, where they take the right tackle Marshall Yanda and put him next to Michael Orr on that left side. But great penetration by Mike DeVito, almost blew that thing up in the end zone.
You have to really be careful with your run selection here. The Jets have been in a 9 or 10 man front. They're running through gaps. Don't be surprised if Flacco doesn't air one out here. You have Bolden down here against Cromartie again.
Yeah, but he's getting help from Leonard over the top right now, John.
From the one, it's play action. Flacco looking, launching with a flag down. Do you believe this? I think this is going to be pass interference again.
Holding on Cromartie.
Yep.
Well, it has been all night.
Wow.
Holy, number 31, defense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
Sixth first down by penalty for Baltimore here tonight.
Well, here it is, bump and run coverage. Looked like pretty good coverage to me that time, man. We're just getting so many flags here. I think these...
You can't play anymore.
Now, some of the other calls I didn't have a problem with. That one was the shakiest.
There's been so many, Mike. I can't remember which one you're talking about.
But again, another first down in a third and long situation, aided by a Jet penalty. McGahee. Loss of one. Back at the five.
And the Jets desperately need a stop here to try to get some field position for this offense. It almost appears as if the Jets don't score on defense, they're not going to score on offense. They have made no movement whatsoever when they've had the football. Critical possession here for the Jet defense.
Well, John, they've only garnered 98 yards on 26 plays at this point with 249 left there in the third quarter. So they're going to need to flip the field.
Second and 10, Flacco. That is caught by Bolden, a couple of yards shy of the first down. We have third and a couple coming up. We have more whistles over here. Let's see, we have a flag. Nope. Yes, no, we do. Here's Rex Ryan. You know, guys, I love you see all the offensive guys with their nicely laminated play sheet and kind of up by their mouth. Rex is like a piece of paper scribbled on there on the other side of that. He calls the defense. He's so involved, and the players believe in him. His players love him. Even the old Baltimore players, they understand the war of words going back and forth. Because when he is your guy, he sticks up for you. When he's not, you're against him. That's simple. Third and three, Flacco got protection, couldn't get Mason. So the Cromartie penalty doesn't burn the Jets here as Revis had the cover.
Kind of surprising that Flacco would choose that side. Derek Mason against Darrell Revis on the other side. The guy he's been getting on has been successful. And that being Anquan Boldema. Look at Revis right here, a little double move. He doesn't bite that at all. Perfect coverage by Darrell Revis. And he's been on the field an awful lot of snaps tonight.
Jets had a nice punt return earlier. It's their best offensive foray of the evening. Brad Smith is edging off from his gunner's spot, taking a look at Sam Cook, trying to come in after it. 16. Picked up well. Cook's kick tumbles down to the rookie Wilson at the 40, who lost the football as he was hit by David Reed. but got back on it. Dwight Lowry and Marcus Smith of Baltimore have at it.
What a great play by the Gunner, rookie David Reed out of Utah. Split a double. Made a heck of a play.
That's why he made the team. Demetrius Williams, the veteran, did not. Plays he can make on teams like that.
That was a hard knock.
Who writes your stuff? You are funny, man. That's great.
We're working on it all afternoon.
Jets ball at the four.
Versus ground and use this guy.
It was the longest play of the night. First down from scrimmage for the Jets since the first quarter. Tomlinson with a run for about 2 yards. Guys, back to Rex Ryan, New York Times Magazine, Hard Knocks, all that other stuff that they did. You know, they kind of put it out there, and Rex even told Michelle Tafoya in the Sunday conversation, in part a recruiting tool. So everybody around the league saw what we do, what we're all about, and it kind of opened the doors and opened eyes around the league when the Jets had NFL Films and HBO in here.
You know, I find it refreshing. You know, so many coaches around this league, their lips move and they say nothing. Rex lays it out there.
Danny Woodhead, who, if you watch the show, is one of the guys you rooted for, made the team again, 5'9". He's at the top of the screen, 27. Sanchez is looking. He's running. He's only getting a couple of yards to the 35-yard line. Put a flag down near the O-line.
Holding, number 60, offense. 10-yard penalty, still second down.
Second one on DeBrickashaw Ferguson tonight.
Three-man rush by the Ravens. Drop eight into coverage. The Jets had to hold.
13th accepted penalty.
Wow. Wayne Hunter in the game. That's at the goal number 78. That's their heavy package for the Jets.
Hey, John, what about the whole Hard Knocks concept for coaches and letting people in to see the entire process?
Look, I think it's creative and great. A lot of fun to cover. That wasn't my style or any style that I've ever seen before. I admire Rex for being himself and having fun with his profession. I wouldn't do it.
From the 47, Sanchez. Complete into Ravens territory to Kotchery at the 34-yard line. So he completes his sixth pass of the night as we end the third quarter. Off we go to the fourth. It's only a four-point game. Monday Night Football doubleheader. The Chiefs and the Chargers follow us tonight. Monday Night Football. So the 49ers have one game, one loss, and one team meeting called after the game when they arrived back in San Francisco last night by Mike Singletary.
Well, that bubble burst real quick out in San Francisco after that performance.
Check in on that next week. Mike Tirico, John Gruden, Ron Jaworski. We start the fourth quarter with 3rd and 6 for the Jets. Ravens coming from the left. One of them, Jared Johnson, stepping up into the pressure of Terrell Suggs. A combo sack, and the Jets have not converted a third down tonight.
Real nice job by the Ravens. They disguised, they showed pressure, then they bailed out. Look at Terrell Suggs coming off the edge against Damian Woody. The inside move, that swim move, gets the sack. But a real nice job by the defense of playing the mind game with Mark Sanchez. They got him to audible against the blitz, and they backed out and played coverage. Suggs off the edge gets the sack.
And John was thinking four down territory if it was incomplete there.
Yeah, it really was. I have to think Zibikowski's going to use very good judgment here.
Weatherford tries to pin them inside the 10. It is stopped outside of the goal line. Good job by Marquise Cole. It'll be inside the 5 after we get a Sports Center right now with Trey Wingo.
All right, Michael, thank you. Updating you on the U.S. Open Men's Championship. Rafa Nadal has won the third set. He's now 2 games away from his 9th slam title, and he would have the career Grand Slam that's currently on ESPN2. Meanwhile, at 10:15, Antonio Gates and the Chargers get set to open up their season against the Kansas City Chiefs. Football after tennis on ESPN2. Now let's go back to the new Meadowlands Stadium.
All right, Trey, thank you. Big night because of the rain in the New York City area as the tennis continues over across the river in Queens. Last drive started at the 2, so does this drive. Keep move. It'll be first and 10, or first and 11 from the 1.
False start, number 86. Offense, half the distance to the goal, still first down.
This is where the crowd can really help your defense. The fans are close to the field. The quarterback's cadence could be negated. The Jets right now trying to get the crowd into it because their offense certainly hasn't. Maybe their defense can.
From the 1, Flacco just keeping, trying to gain some space. Gets a half yard.
And I just have to think that Brian Schottenheimer, the offensive coordinator of the Jets, is standing over there with Mark Sanchez contemplating what to do to move the football with their next possession.
John, they need a single play. It's 10-6. They need a play. Can they dial up a play to get a touchdown?
Well, they haven't shown it thus far.
Well, they've had the Ravens in horrific field position the entire second half. They've generated 3 turnovers from their defense. And they're going to need another one here.
Two tight ends for the Ravens. Give to LaRon McClain. He's not going anywhere. Forward progress at the 1. Jason Taylor, David Harris, Mike DeVito. Third and long coming up.
Talk about controlling the line of scrimmage. Watch the white hats create penetration and stalemates on the line of scrimmage.
Great shot there.
Guys Taylor. Like Sean Ellis, this is one of the best run defenders in the last decade. Pro Bowler last year. He can still stuff you and dominate versus the run as good as most guys I've seen.
I'm going to look to Bolden against Cromartie up on top if I'm Joe Flacco.
Turn in hand, McClain. They won't get the full room for the punt snap. Jets defense has done a terrific job. See Joe Klecko's name back there in the Ring of Honor. We saw Joe today. This kind of reminds me of the New York sack exchange days, although not the pass rush with Abdul Salam and Marty Lyons and Klecko and Mark Gastineau. But the defense is what gets this team going and the fans fired up. Now can the offense just do enough?
One play.
Yep. Punt return coming, Jim Leonard. Sam Cook kicking. Not the full 15 yards for the deep snap. You gotta get rid of it quickly. Good kick. Good stuff. 54 yards. Leonard for the 44 turns it straight up. And Jim Leonard brings it essentially to the edge of field goal range at the 34. If the Jets offense can just go forward, not backward, they may have a chance to get within 1. 1 second under 12 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Beautiful shot to the New York metropolitan area with tonight's aerial coverage brought to you by DirecTV. 10-6. Jets offense has been poor. But they're down 4 and with great field position at the Ravens 35. Tomlinson inside for a gain of 2, maybe even 1. We'll see. You know, John, look at the number of plays the Jets have run tonight. Very quick review of the offensive
field. Well, not only
that,
how about the field position? They haven't done anything with this great field position. I don't know if Dustin Keller is at the stadium tonight, and Braylon Edwards hasn't seen any action. I just think they've got to mix it up, throw the football. This secondary of the Ravens isn't even at full strength.
No, Ed Reed. He's out for the first 6 weeks. There's Sanchez with play action. Checking down, here's Richardson. Ray Lewis trying to bring him down. It was almost a horse collar, but Richardson shook free, and it's at the 30.
Let's take a look at the last 7 drives. You know, you see where you start. Pretty good field position at times. Punt, field goal. There's a lot of punts there, Jaws. And this third down, I really think the Jets are in 4 down territory. Don't be surprised if they look at it that way.
No gains of 48-yard field goal. You still think 4 downs here?
I do.
All right.
5-6. 5-6. 5-6. Graham. Reach the 10. Reach the
3rd and 5. Here they all come. Sanchez got rid of it. Cotchery couldn't hang on. Jericho Cotchery, sure-handed usually, Couldn't pull that in. He only had one drop there a couple of years ago. Couldn't grab that one.
Here comes the full blitz. It's all out Baltimore Raven blitz, and you're going to see Kotchery at the top of the screen run a quick out for the first down. Sanchez laid it right in there.
Defense and tight game, and that's what we have, 10-9. Mark Sanchez and the Jets have run only 33 plays. They have only four first downs, one of them by penalty. Ray Lewis and the Ravens defense looking as strong as ever. The Jets have not really challenged them in a lot of ways, but it's a one-point game with 10 and a half to go.
Yeah, hanging around.
Short kick. Parmalee runs up to get it. And he's submarined at the 27-yard line. Trey Wingo in the studio.
All right, Michael, thank you. A big part of that ground-and-pound offense last year for the Jets, Thomas Jones. 1,402 yards last year, but he's now playing for the Chiefs. They get set for the Chargers. 10:15 kickoff on ESPN2. Let's go back to the Meadowlands.
Okay, Trey, thanks again. That game's going to start on ESPN2 because our game got started late with a 15-minute lightning delay that happened about an hour or so before kickoff, pushed everything back a little bit. But we'll get the Chiefs and Chargers going next door over on ESPN2 and bring it back here when this game wraps up. Darrell Revis has played most of the snaps for the Jets. They haven't tested him very much. Covering Anquan Boldin, bottom of your screen, and on first down, a flag is down as Flacco goes the other way. Cromartie almost cut under and intercepted the pass intended for Todd Heat. Two men in motion at the same time with Boldin, I believe.
There's no question about that call.
Illegal shift, numbers 33 and 81, offense. 5-yard penalty, still first down.
Well, you can't put a guy in motion while one of your receivers is moving. And right now, against that heavy personnel grouping that the Ravens have on the field, the Jets counter that with just three defensive backs. They put an extra linebacker in. Big second down play here for the Ravens offense. They've got to get it in third and manageable. That's where Flacco wanted to be in this ballgame.
Well, their third and longs have been terrific because they get a penalty every time they get third yeah. and 18 or 20.
Ray Rice, the running back. Flacco taking a shot for Heat downfield. That's incomplete. Well covered by Cromartie on the tight end. We'll have third down coming up.
This is when the Jets normally, once again, they want to get after you. I would be surprised if we see the total blitz. Flacco's been ready for it. The Ravens offensive line's been ready for it. They've had success on those disaster downs, third and seven or more, against this Jets defense. But it is Rex Ryan. He never takes conservative approach. He may come with the all-out blitz again and put the onus on his secondary to cover man-to-man.
Usman Zada down here towards the bottom and now in motion. Here comes the Jets pressure from Flacco's left. He runs away and completes to Boldin. Anquan first down right near the 40.
Wow, there comes the New York Jet overload blitz. You're going to see a bunch of New York Jets coming off Joe Flacco's left side. Take a look at it over here. It's a zone blitz. They're going to drop to the right of the screen. But how about Joe Flacco's mobility? How about that throw? Big-time play
it.
By Joe
you
Flacco.
You nailed it. Extend the play. Feel the pressure. That's pocket movement. That's mobility from the quarterback. Just by a second or two, allow the receiver to get open. Flacco did it.
It is Baltimore debut. Boldin over 100 yards. 106. So the throw run with Rice to the 45-yard line. Take us under 9.5. Well, third down has been terrific for the Ravens tonight. That's usually not the case against the Jets. And we were saying earlier, as you look at Flacco's third down numbers, that is very misleading, third down conversions. So for context, we've got a third and 9, a third and 13, a third and 28, a third and 9, a third and 10, a third and 5, a third and 7, and a third and 10 two more times, all converted against this Jets defense. That's rare
very,
against the Rex Ryan
very
defense.
Rare.
Yeah.
Usually that's when they're creating the interception, the sack, the fumble.
Second down with 5 rushing. It's Boldin again against Kyle Wilson, banging forward Couple yards shy of the first down.
Yeah, I just love watching Anquan Boldin catch the football. You know, we all talk about, you know, speed and quickness, separation. How about catching the football? You watch the ball come to Anquan Boldin. Look at the hands. Watch him just snag that thing out of the air. His shoulders down and gets yards after the catch.
Yeah, but he plays with a rage, this guy. He refuses to go down. One of the great competitors that play that position, Anquan Boldin.
What a fit. Need for the Ravens and the personality of the Ravens. Boldin. Third and two. Flacco's going to throw for it again. He's got heat for another first down into Jets territory. It'll take us under 8 minutes.
You know, you go back to Anquan Boldin. How about the last time he played here in New York? There he is up top against Cromartie. He works hard. Had him inside again on a slant. But the last time Boldin played here, he had, I don't know, what, 40 titanium screws put in his cheekbone, Mike? He took one of the great hits of all time. And here he is. He looks like it never happened.
Took that hit, and he played a couple weeks later. It was the most incredible recoveries you'll ever want to see. I mean, you think of a tough guy, that's an NFL tough guy, Anquan Boldin.
Rice left. Got a good block at the end from Michael Orr and got to the 42-yard line. This is a very scary scene. You remember week 4, 2008. Boldin was hit. Eric Smith, who's starting at safety for the Jets tonight, ends up with that hit to the face that ended up doing the damage. 7 plates, 40 titanium screws. He only missed 2 games. You see Kurt Warner there. Kurt Warner was so disturbed by the injury, he even thought of retiring at that point. It had really affected Kurt so much, but as we said, only a couple games later, and Smith, who got the hit, was fine, suspended a game. But he and Boldin spoke right after, and Boldin told him, keep playing that way. That was a freak accident. Ray Rice carried, no game. We got a third down coming up. So speaking of Warner, remember a preseason game we did with the Cardinals, and Warner was on Twitter?
I remember well.
Kurt's tweeting again. He said, y'all, I'm watching my man Q balling. I know Kurt talked like that.
Wow.
One of the best competitors I ever played with and continues to show everyone why, Kurt Warner tweeting tonight. I miss throwing to him. Cardinal fans miss you throwing too, Kurt.
Well, the one thing, no matter what happens on this drive for the Ravens, they flip the field. They will back the Jets up if they don't convert this first down. But here comes the heat.
All out juice right here.
Means man coverage downfield, and he couldn't get it off in time. The pass was incomplete, deflected, and we'll get to 4th down and 5.
You know, that's one thing about Rex Ryan. You can get him once on a blitz. You might even get him twice. But when the game is on the line, there he is, one of the great crunch time blitz callers there is. Look at these New York Jets on the line of scrimmage, man coverage everywhere else. That takes a lot of guts to call that blitz with that coverage in that situation. You got to give him credit. He reminds me of his dad.
See if Sam Cook can pin the Jets inside their 10. Jim Leonard calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 7. So a Jet offense that has 133 yards tonight, 93 yards away from the goal line with 6:13 to go. They only need a field goal to take the lead. The Jets offense has only 4 first downs tonight. One of them came by penalty, yet they are still in the game, 10-9. Now can they mount something down the field to get into field goal range? It has been all LaDainian Tomlinson at the running back in this second half. Drive start from the 8. Here's LT. Right side. First down to the 26. A gain of 18. He has runs of 21 and 18 here tonight in his Jet debut.
Well, that's the Jets' 34th play of this game. They should be well rested and fresh for this drive here with less than 6 minutes to go.
It's a zone running play. It gives Tomlinson a 3-way go. That time he just pressed it and went north and south. But Tomlinson told us, Jaws, I love this zone blocking scheme because I can bounce it outside, I can take what's there, or I can cut it back.
Green and cut. Kill, kill. Okay. Green 90. Green and cut.
5.5 left. Tomlinson again finds a little crease. Gets out to the 33. 8th all-time rusher in National Football League history. Great. Hall of Fame career in San Diego for 9 years. Now comes to the Jets when people say maybe the tank is empty. Good preseason. Good runs here. He gets a blow as Green comes in now.
Yeah, he just tapped his second-year pro, Sean Green, on the behind and said, let's go. They need Sean Green to pick up the slack here in the fourth quarter.
Well, you put the ball on the ground, you're not going to be in the backfield much for a Rex Ryan team.
Jensen without Santonio Holmes suspended four games, so when they go four receivers, they have some guys who cannot play at the same level, and Green with a drop.
You know, Sean Green is going to have a meeting with Rex Ryan tomorrow, I'm sure. Two fumbles, a drop pass. He just doesn't look into the football game. And when you're filling Thomas Jones' shoes, you got to respond.
But, John, Sanchez is not looking downfield. You see how quick he turned his head out to Sean Green? You've got to let that play develop down the field. Look for a downfield throw before you go to that wide route. Way too quick dumping it off.
Hey, Jaws, that's what they've been telling him. Check down, check down. Don't worry about taking the shots. Be smart and safe. Third and four. They haven't picked up a third down tonight. Still have it. Brought down. Sacked by Halote Nata, who beat the first-year starter at guard, Matt Slauson.
Well, you wonder when it's going to show up. Matt Slauson replaces Alan Faneca, the perennial All-Pro. In the big play of the game, Halote Nata whips him for the sack. You'll see Halote Nata right there over number 68, Matt Slauson. And you just see the bull rush and throws him out of the way. Halote Nata at 350 pounds with a just bull rush.
The punters have done a pretty good job here tonight. Very effective. This field position battle. Weatherford's kick for the sideline. 49 yards. Zivikowski brought down by Drew Coleman. You saw the shot as we were going to the replay of Sanchez limping over toward the sideline. Had left knee surgery in the offseason, wearing a knee brace that was tested by the power of Halote Nata. 4:27 to go. Just a few miles from here earlier tonight, just a few moments ago, Rafael Nadal won the U.S. Open Tennis Championship to complete the career slam. Those of you who are watching that, welcome over. Ravens 10, Jets 9, Chiefs Chargers follow us. Monday Night Football opening doubleheader. Jets offense has been bad. Ravens trying to close the game out. Flacco downfield for Todd Heap. He leaps and caught it. Hasn't been touched. Can get up and run. And now they're going to call his progress down there at the 39.
What a gutty call by Cam Cameron. He goes to play action pass. Heap one-on-one with the smaller size Leonard. And you just put it up and let Todd Heap go get it. Cam Cameron knew, Jaws, that the Jets went to that extra linebacker and he could get that matchup. Heap is 6'6". Leonard is 5'8".
Yeah, as much as everyone loves Jim Leonard, you get him in man coverage, he can be a liability.
Gain of 35. Ray Rice runs left. Hill still going. Couldn't bring him down. Gain of about 8 yards near the 30-yard line with 3.5 to go. Heap was hard to get up after he laid out there. May have lost his breath. He comes over to the sideline to try to catch his wind.
Well, that was a 69th play for the Baltimore Ravens as opposed to 37 for the New York Jets. That Jets defense has spent a lot of time on the field right now. I think at this point, you're going to see the Ravens go to their power football game.
Flacco's going to use all the clock right here. And they're doing a nice job with fullback LaRon McClain coming out of all kind of alignments to block the point of attack.
They give to McClain as he cuts inside for the first down. Here's Trey Wingo in the studio.
All right, Michael, thank you very much. We are getting set for kickoff on ESPN2. Chargers and Chiefs, San Diego trying to win the AFC West for a fifth straight year. As soon as your game is over, we'll get the Chargers-Chiefs back from ESPN2 and on to ESPN. Meanwhile, let's get back to the finish between the Ravens and the Jets. Michael.
All right, great scene there and sound at Arrowhead. Brad Nessler and Trent Dilfer, who helped the Ravens win the Super Bowl a decade ago. We'll have the call for you coming up here in a minute.
I thought McClain in the first down, but the spot's going to be just shy.
So a third down coming up here. And a run could take it to the two-minute warning.
Well, I'm sure the Jets will burn a timeout.
Exactly. The Jets should be doing that.
which Dallas did not do last night.
Boy, you keep mentioning that, Mike. And you're right.
It's time management.
Yeah, well, no. Well, we could spend an hour discussing that.
Well, this is where the Jets are very good themselves on defense. They're going to be looking for the quarterback sneak. Play selection right here will be critical. The Ravens need 1 inch.
They got Matt Burke, a 13-year veteran. Chris Jenkins on the game. Joe Flacco at 6'6", 238. What a quarterback sneak.
I'm for that.
Hey, we finally agreed on something.
Killed me, Jaws. They've done it a couple of times off the goal line to get space here in this quarter. Third and inches. They try Flacco doing just that. Let's see where they spot him at the bottom of the mosh pit. Clock is stopped here for measurement purposes at 2:08.
As our friend John Madden would always say, that's the right foot spot. It's going to be a first down.
Bring the chains out to check. As you see, the Jets have all their timeouts remaining, so be prudent to use one here if it is a first down. By a nose. First down. 11th third down conversion for the Ravens. The Jets have none.
Well, 21 first downs for the Baltimore Ravens. 5 for the Jets. And that's the facts. 21-5. That's about as lopsided a game as we've had in a while, guys.
Number of plays, John, again. The Ravens up to 71 plays to 37.
Jets will not use a timeout here and take it to the two-minute warning. You talk about first downs. The fewest first downs in Jets history is 6. That was the game after Lou Holtz quit before the last game of the season.
Trey Wingo here with you in our studios. Chargers and Chiefs just underway. Kansas City about to punt it away after going 3 and out. That game on ESPN2. As soon as the Ravens and the Jets are over, we'll send that game from ESPN2 to ESPN. Let's get back to the finish at the Meadowlands. Mike Tirico and company.
All right, Matt Castle's missed a pass already to start. Matt Castle, Mark Sanchez, a couple of USC quarterbacks in the conversation here. It's been a very poor night for the Jets offense. No other way to slice it. 7-14 is Sanchez. The Ravens getting a big game from Anquan Boldin. The Jets rookie Kyle Wilson picked on by Boldin a few times. Cromartie's been picked on. 2-minute warning. Jets full complement of timeouts.
Haloti Ngata at tight end.
Lost him a couple for Rice. Jets will take the timeout here with a minute 55 to go. Have to stop him here and then hope with no timeouts you can move back down and get in field goal range if the Ravens don't kick one. So for John Harbaugh, you know, this is a team that has been to the playoffs and won a playoff game the last 2 years. The only team in the AFC, not Indianapolis, not New England, not San Diego. These guys have. And when John Harbaugh came in, it was kind of an eggshell deal because it was a defense. It's Ray Lewis's team, Rex Ryan's personality. Now he left. Ed Reed's still there. They hope to have him back mid-year. What were you going to do? Well, Harbaugh has won these guys over these couple of years and infiltrated a little more offense to the defense-only style.
Yeah, it wasn't an extreme makeover, but what was a makeover? In today's NFL, you've got to be able to throw the football. It's critical.
Second and 12, Rice left and stay in bounds. The big loss now takes them to Jason Taylor. Looks like he's cramping as he's stopped that play. Takes him back to out of field goal range or very deep field goal range here.
That's a big play. When you play outside linebacker in a 3-4 defense, you keep hearing about setting the edge, set the edge. Don't let the ball outside of you. And Jason Taylor does an excellent job of setting the edge and allowing his posse to get there for the tackle. Give this guy credit. I think he wanted to return to Miami. Bill Parcells wanted to go a different direction. He called Dan Marino. He called Zach Taylor, some of the legendary, Zach Thomas, I should say, legendary Dolphin players. They said, hey, if you feel like you can still play, we don't care where you play, just play. And
So far, he's played a heck of a football game.
He played the run very well tonight. He's long with those arms. You can't get to his body, and he makes plays in the running game.
From here, a field goal will be 55 yards, and they look to throw and do throw to Dixon, and thank you very much. Saved me a timeout with a minute 44 to go.
Well, they're trying to get some kind of completion, Mike, to get in field goal position. They were in an unbalanced line. They looked for their rookie tight end, Ed Dixon, with the safe protection. Good decision by Flacco to throw it away. Mm-hmm. But I really think they were looking for a 7 or 8 yard gain to give Billy Cundiff a chance to kick a field goal.
But it's a huge benefit for the Jets there with a minute 44 left to have a timeout now,
sure
come
is
down the field, because now they're not going to kick a field goal. The field goal wins, so a big play would be huge for the Jets' chances. This one's straight up in the air. Leonard's going to come down and get it at the 16 with a fair catch. So that tightens up the window a little bit. I will say this. The Jets' kicker is Nick Folk, right? There was a game that we did on a Monday night in Buffalo.
Yep.
That the Dallas Cowboys had absolutely no business on the history of the planet winning.
Yep.
And Nick Folk kicked a 53-yard field goal at the end of the game to win. And he did it twice.
Twice.
Yeah, yeah, but let's come back to Mark Sanchez. This is what you want to see from your young quarterback. You need to get a field goal. One timeout, a minute 37 left. You have to get it done in a two-minute drill.
And you need 47 yards to get down in Folk's range pretty much. So that's what's ahead for the Jets. See, that movement was on the right tackle, Damian Woody.
False start, number 67, offense.
And all these dummy snap counts, all these false counts, that's about the third time the Brickshaw has been victimized. I kind of get the feeling these Jet offensive linemen just want to get up and go. Actually, that's Damian Woody.
149 yards offense, 125 penalty yards tonight.
You know, you can still work the middle of the field. You have one timeout left. You don't need to panic quite yet.
From the 13, Sanchez with a little time underneath Tomlinson. 82, down by Tavares Gooden.
When I said work the middle of the field, I didn't mean a little five-yard check down. You got to take a few shots down the field.
Well, it's been predominantly a two-deep zone for the most part. Get somebody between those two safeties, and don't be so quick to check it down.
How about getting a playoff here? You're exchanging sides with receivers. 15 seconds wasted. Sanchez can't take a sack. Did a good job there to get rid of it. The Ravens are saying there's nobody on that half of the field who's an eligible receiver. But the Jets pointing out that he's out of the tackle box. Third down.
Well, you have to think Brian Schottenheimer has a play for this situation. These two have not been on the same page. They don't appear to be on the same page now, Jaws.
Yeah, this has been a pretty ugly performance by the Jets offense.
It looks a lot like the Jets offense, but first team offense in the preseason. They did not look good at any stretch. Against a three-man Raven rush, Sanchez throws. Braylon Edwards first down at the 30. Timeout Jets. 57 seconds left. Their final timeout.
Well, they've moved the ball about 10 yards, and I'm exhausted.
You know, I believe you have to save that timeout. You just got the first down. You want to have an opportunity to throw it down the field and then use your timeout to reset your offense. You always like to keep one in your pocket.
Again, just for the perspective, how far do you have to get? What was Nick Folk doing earlier tonight? Able to knock in a field goal. He's been the entire Jets offense, one in the first, one in the second, and earlier in the fourth quarter, able to hit a bit longer field goal. We mentioned his career long was on a Monday night, 53 yards in Buffalo in 2007.
Well, the Jets are going to have to push the football. Look for Braylon Edwards down here at the bottom of your screen. He's their big play receiver.
Adam.
Sanchez look middle, comes back down, incomplete to Tomlinson. You have to get out of bounds if you catch one of those here, and not gaining a lot of yards and letting the clock run. He's useless.
Well, the Ravens are playing that too deep, but they are buzzing Ray Lewis, the middle linebacker, 25 yards down the field. They're not going to give him that hole, that middle of the field to attack.
And oftentimes, the Ravens are rushing three Men. And it's eight in coverage. Mark's going to have time to push it down the field. Set up and give it a look.
52 seconds left. Sanchez throws middle. What a shot by Lewis on Dustin Keller. As the ball arrived, shoulder pad level and down, so there's no penalty.
See if you can hear this. This is a hard knock. The master of disaster, 15 years. He's been lighting people up over the middle.
And a perfectly clean hit.
Third and 10, no timeouts, 47 seconds left.
You stay there, you stay 5 minutes.
Ravens are showing blitz. They can't blitz this.
They did.
Overload.
Underneath, off the hands of Cotchery, almost taken in for the game closer by Corey Redding, who they picked up from Seattle, and the Jets are down to a final play.
Well, I give Greg Madison, the defensive coordinator of Baltimore, a lot of credits. Blitzing in that situation was the last thing I expected, clearly the last thing the Jets expected.
However, John, it was one of those safe blitzes, one of those overloads where they, you know, had the deep middle of the field covered. So if you did beat it, it wasn't going to be a big play.
Fourth and 10, you have to give yourself a chance for at least a pass interference call. You've got to push it.
Gotta have it here. Sanchez throws for Keller. He's got it. Did he get the first down? Where's the spot? The ball was in the right hand. He's short of the first down, and the game will end there. In the last 2 minutes, upstairs in the replay booth, they can look at the spot to make sure it's correct. But Keller.
The ball is short of the line of the game. The ball goes over to Baltimore.
I don't even know if there's a question about this.
No, and he's got the ball in the right hand. Not even close.
No.
Wow. Well, that summarizes the Jets offense tonight, guys. There's the one open guy you have, and it's very hard to get. He's trying to get his feet down, but, you know, you've seen veteran receivers, Keller in his third year, get the ball in your left hand, stick it out to break the plane.
Well, New York's got a lot of work to do in their passing game, and that's an understatement.
Historically inept night for the Jets offense. And a heck of a win for Ray Lewis. John Harbaugh, and, you know, Rex Ryan built the defense, but the Ravens defense outdid the Jets defense here. Six first downs, tying the fewest in team history, fewest pass yards since 06, most penalty yards in 22 seasons, and only 44 plays. Well, New England's defensive staff will not have a lot to look through as they get ready for next week.
You have a real short week, and guess who coming in next week? The red-hot New England Patriots.
A lot of talk in the offseason of all the pieces the Jets added on the offensive side. Can they be more dynamic and grow? Maybe hard to measure against one of the best defenses in the league, but as you said, John, a lot to do. We'll get Santonio Holmes back after 4 weeks. So Rex Ryan and the Jets, the hug for Ed Reed, one of his former players. For all the talk and conversation, they go to 0-1 and get the Patriots next week. While the Ravens have a very tough division game coming up against Cincinnati.